Hi, welcome to Samdhana Yoga. I'm Melody White, founder of Samdhana Yoga. I appreciate your presence and being with us here today. We're going to do a basic vinyasa class today. So basic meaning that it's between 8 and 10 vinyasas, and there's not a lot of peak postures in here, but our focus is on opening the 7 major areas of the body. With us today are my good friends and beautiful people in my life, Linda Reed and Jody Brinkley, so I'm grateful for that behind the camera. Josh and Lisa. Mm-hmm. So anyway, let's get started. We'll start class today in child's pose. So if you guys will go ahead and come to child's pose. And starting in child's pose, very standard way to start. Doesn't have to start that way, but this gives us a chance to let the heart face down, get close to the earth, and let go. Begin to let go of whatever happened before you started taking the class. And just release those thoughts. Settle in with your breath, start to observe it. You're here for about another minute. Begin to step into your ujjayi breathing. Deepen that breath, deepen the inhales and the exhales. Feel the rib cage expand against the thighs and on the side bodies. And on the exhale, feel that descending motion of the heart. For me, child is such an awesome place to come. It's where I can really let go and begin to center and get in ready for my practice. Last three breaths here. We're going to make our way to hip circles, which is one of the primary movements. So on an inhale, we're going to lean over to the right hip. Now as we exhale, we're going to pull over to the left, big wide hip circles. This will help take the tug off the low back and help start to opening that low back for stronger movement. It's one of the four primary movements of the spine. They'll be taking 5. You'll take 5 in one direction, right to left. And then eventually 5 in the other direction, left to right. Once you have found equal number to both sides, we'll meet back in child. Once you're back in child's pose, the exhale's pulled you back into child. We're going to move between child and modified plank. And you want to move from your center. So bring your focus just behind your belly button. And you'll unfold the body on the inhale. So we're going to do it 3 times. So on the inhale, roll forward, modified plank. And on the exhale, gently push back to child. 2 more with your breath pattern. Meeting back in child when you're done. And then still moving from that belly, from just behind the belly. Inhale, hands and knees, tabletop. Exhale, round for cat. Now, in your cat, gently sit the hips back just 1 inch or 2 towards the heels. Just a little more back flexion. 1 more full breath here. And then inhale, come to neutral, and exhale here. You can hear the girls breathing. Inhale, come into cow pose, heart forward, tailbone up, back extension. Exhale, round for cat. Inhale, come forward and open for cow. And exhale to cat. Take three more with your breath pattern. We'll all be at different places with our breath. So after you've gotten those three, then you'll take an inhale to neutral and the exhale to down dog. So always feel free to move at your pace. That's why there'll be times that you'll not hear me talking, that so that it can give you space to do it with your breath. Now, once you're in down dog, inhale, lift to toes. Exhale, lower the heels. Then inhale, lift to toes. Exhale, right heel down, left knee bends. Inhale, lift to toes. Exhale, other side. Inhale, lift to toes. Exhale, drop both heels. Inhale, right leg lifts. Exhale, right foot between the hands, runner's lunge, and pause. Pull the spine nice and long. Exhaling here. Next inhale, grounded airplane, back leg lifts. Exhale, fold, left foot by the right. Inhale, halfway lift, and exhale, fold. Then bend the knees, and on an inhale, slowly rise to standing. Fingertips reach, and a big sigh out through the mouth, hands to heart center. Inhale, reach up, soft bend in the knees, and bring it down to a fold. Inhale, halfway lift, exhale, fold. Soften the knees, palm the mat, left foot steps back. You're in a runner's lunge. Right knee pulls in for cheetah. Inhale, take it up to 3-point. Exhale, pull out to plank, dropping right foot by the left. Take an inhale here. Exhale, lower down to the belly. We're making our way to Sphinx pose. Elbows come under the shoulders, forearms lay on the earth. Reach through the toes, heart pulls forward, shoulder blades roll back and down, and then bring your gaze slightly forward and down. And you have 5-6 more breaths here. So again, you might can hear the breathing, which is good. We want that steady, it's very soothing, but you won't hear me for a little bit. Last full breath here. Now take an inhale. Exhale, return the heart to the earth. Hands behind the shoulders. Gently push it back to child. Inhale, come forward, hands and knees. Exhale, tuck the toes and lift the hips, down dog. Inhale, lift to toes. Exhale, lower the heels. Inhale, lift to toes. Exhale, left heel down, right knee bends. Inhale, lift to toes, and exhale, other side. Inhale, lift to toes, and exhale, drop both heels. Starting movement again. Inhale, left leg lifts. Exhale, left foot between the hands. You're in a runner's lunge. Pull the spine nice and long. Bring the gaze down. Exhaling here. Next inhale, grounded airplane, back leg lifts. Exhale, fold, right foot by the left. Inhale, pull the spine nice and long. Exhale, fold. Bend the knees, and on an inhale, gently roll up to standing. Fingertips reach, and then big sigh out through the mouth, hands to heart center. Inhale, reach up, back to Ujjayi breath, soft bend in the knees, bow, swan dive. Inhale, halfway lift, exhale, fold. Soften the knees, palm the mat, right foot steps back, left knee pulls in cheetah. Inhale, take it up to 3-point. Exhale, pull forward to plank. Inhale here in your plank, exhale lower to the belly. Setting up for Sphinx again, elbows under the shoulders, reach through the toes, lengthen the tailbone. Heart pulls forward, gazes slightly forward and down. 5-6 more breaths here. One more full round of breath. Take an inhale. Exhale, heart comes down, hands behind the shoulders, gently push it back to child. Inhale, come forward, hands and knees. Exhale, tuck the toes, lift the hips, down dog. Inhale, lift to toes. Exhale, lower the heels and breathe here. Now you have five full breaths. So we've warmed the hamstrings up a little bit, but just by, well, hip flexion, hip extension, just through those two sun A's. And now we want to hold and enjoy down dog and its benefits. Very soothing to vata, very energizing for those who are kapha. One more full round of breath here. Now inhale, lift the toes. Exhale, lower the heels. Walk the hands back towards the feet. You're in a forward fold at the back of your mat. Once you're here, inhale, halfway lift, and exhale, fold. Because the heart's been down, we're going to come up, bend the knees, and on an inhale, rise to standing, fingertips reach. Big sigh out through the mouth, hands to heart center. Nice. And then inhale, reach the hands forward. Exhale, bring them behind you. Clasp the hands and roll the shoulders back. And then hands can move as far away from the body as they'd like to open the shoulders a little bit. And we're going to just work on the kidney meridian. So on an inhale, we're going to lift up to the toes, which places us right on the K27, the ball of the foot. Exhale, lower the heels and lift the toes. Then inhale, lift the heels. Exhale, lower the heels and lift the toes. Nice. Inhale one more time. Lift the heels. Exhale, lower the heels, lift the toes. Then plant the feet, the toes back down. Lengthen the tailbone. Pull the belly button back towards the backbone. Hands, clasp hands behind the hips now. On an inhale, lift the heart up. And exhale, gaze up and breathe here. When you're in stargazer, or some people call this stargazer, and we're just in a little bit of back extension. If you feel any pressure in your low back, certainly come up out of it, meaning lift up back up a little bit and then maybe restart. Tailbone needs to be nice and lengthened. Two more breaths. Now on your next exhale, release the hands. Inhale, reach the hands up. Exhale, big sigh, hands to heart. Inhale, reach up, soft bend in the knees and bring it down to a fold. Inhale, halfway lift, and exhale, fold. Then inhale, pull the spine nice and long. Exhale, bend the left knee, left hand down, and inhale, right hand to sky for a twist. Exhale, right hand down, bend the right knee. Inhale, left hand to sky for a twist. Exhale, left hand down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Bend the knees. On an inhale, slowly rise to standing. Fingertips reach. Big exhale, out through the mouth, hands to heart. Moving in for side body length, lateral flexion. Inhale, reach the hands up. Exhale, right hand holds the left wrist. Because that was our last opening on that side. Now, push through the feet, lengthen the tailbone. Inhale, push the left palm up. And on the exhale, come over to the right. Make sure your shoulder blades are drawn together and the left arm is behind the left ear, and it's a left side body stretch. Gaze can be up, or it can, if it bothers your neck, it can certainly be forward. Always listening to your body. Next inhale, reach it up, separate the hands, drop the shoulders, big sigh out through the mouth, hands to heart. Inhale, reach up, soft bend in the knees and bring it down to a fold. So we're still moving with bent knees right here. Inhale, halfway lift, exhale, fold. We'll take twist again, heart pulls forward, right knee bends, right hand down, inhale, left hand to sky. Exhale, left hand down, bend the left knee and inhale, right hand to sky. Exhale, right hand down. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, fold. Bend the knees. Inhale, slowly rise. Fingertips reach. Big sigh out through the mouth. Hands to heart center. Moving in for right side body stretch. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, right hand, left hand holds right wrist. Inhale, push the palm up, lengthen the tailbone. Exhale, over to the left for right side body stretch. Breathing here. Next inhale, reach the hands up, separate the hands, drop the shoulders, big sigh out through the mouth, hands to heart center. Inhale, reach up, soft bend in the knees and bring it down to a fold. Inhale, halfway lift, exhale, fold. Now we're gonna hold this fold, so we're gonna help the hamstrings a little bit right here. Take an inhale, exhale, bend the knees deeply like you're sitting in a chair. Inhale, straighten, and exhale, bend. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, bend. Inhale, straighten, pull the heart forward. Exhale, fold and hold. You have 5-6 more breaths here. So bending and straightening right there helps decrease the firing of that muscle spindle receptor, helps the message going to the brain to say, quit tightening. So it gives you, and it also is grounding. It's called the elephant in a grounding activity. Three more breaths here. Release any bind. On an inhale, pull the spine nice and long. And on the exhale, turn the toes out. Sit down to handy squat. And hold and breathe here. And hands can be wherever it suits you. Palms, I like to press into my palms and pull, try to separate the collarbones and help open the chest and the shoulders here. And then push into the triceps and help open the hips here. And gaze can be, eyes can be closed. That's my favorite place. Or down, and take about 3 or 4 more breaths here. Take an inhale. And as you exhale, return the hands to the earth, lift the hips up, turn the toes forward, inhale, halfway lift, and exhale, fold. This time, push into the feet, and on an inhale, rise, fingertips reach. Big sigh out through the mouth, hands to heart center. So all that we've done so far has been to attend the spine and warm up the hamstrings and start to get in the hips a little bit. 3 prana building breaths, inhale, reach up. Keep inhaling. There's no exhale here. You're gathering prana, the energy that's above us in the heavens. Now hold this breath. Lift the heart. Spread the wings. Beautiful, guys. Reach it up. Big sigh out through the mouth. Hands to heart. 2 more. Inhale, take it up. Gather that rich prana in. Your body might even sway heel to toe or whatever works for you. Now hold the breath, lift the heart, spread the wings. Extend your energy to every part of your being. Reach it back up. Big sigh out through the mouth, hands to heart. This last one is at your own count. So inhale, reach it up. Gather as much prana as you want. Hold, extend, you know, whenever you want, and we'll meet in heart center. And so those are cleansing breaths, things to help let go. And then we're back to Ujjayi breath. Inhale, reach up, push into the big toes and bow, swan dive. Inhale, halfway lift, exhale, fold. Then walk the hands out to down dog. Check in with your breath connection. Inhale, lift to toes, exhale, lower the heels. Inhale, right leg lifts. Exhale, right foot between the hands. Inhale, grounded airplane, back leg lifts. Exhale, fold, left foot by the right. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise, fingertips reach. Big sigh, hands to heart. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, bow, swan dive. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Left foot steps back. Spin the back heel down. Inhale, cartwheel open, warrior two. Exhale here. We're going to do some dynamic movement here. So on an inhale, we're going to straighten that front leg and pull the right hand in. Exhale, push and bend. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, bend. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, bend. Inhale, straight leg reverse, reach it up. Exhale, cartwheel down, runner's lunge. Right knee pulls in, cheetah. Inhale, take it up to 3-point. Exhale, pull it back to cheetah. Place the right knee down. We're moving into modified side plank. Kickstand the right shin. And then inhale, the left hand reaches to sky. Now on the exhale, take that left arm behind the left ear and reach towards the mirror. Push into the blade of the left foot. Hold and breathe here, 3 more breaths. This is modified side plank. Now inhale, left hand reaches up. Exhale, left hand down on the left toes, right knee in cheetah. Inhale, take it up to 3-point. Exhale, pull forward to plank. Inhale here, exhale lower. And inhale into your cobra, up dog, sphinx, whatever works for you, and we'll meet in down dog. Inhale, lift the toes. Exhale, lower the heels. Inhale, left leg lifts. Exhale, left foot between the hands, runner's lunge. Next inhale, grounded airplane, back leg lifts. Exhale, fold, right foot meets the left. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise, fingertips reach. Big sigh, hands to heart. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, bow, swan dive. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Right foot steps back. Spin the back heel down. Inhale, cartwheel open, warrior two. Exhaling here. Then taking that dynamic movement. Inhale, straighten the front leg. Left hand pulls in. Exhale, push and bend. You're working with energy. Inhale, pull it in. Exhale, bend. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, bend. Inhale, straight leg reverse, reach it up. Exhale, cartwheel down, runner's lunge. Left knee pulls in, cheetah. Inhale, take it up to 3-point. Exhale, pull it back to cheetah. Gently place the left knee down, kickstand the left shin. Roll into the blade of that right foot. Inhale, right hand reaches to sky, and exhale, right arm behind the right ear for more side body length. Couple more breaths here. Now inhale, right hand reaches up. Exhale, right hand down on the right toes, left knee in cheetah. Inhale, take it up to 3-point. Exhale, pull forward to plank. Left foot by the right. Inhale here, exhale lower. Move through your vinyasa as it suits you. We'll meet in down dog. Inhale, lift the toes. Exhale, lower the heels. Inhale, right leg lifts. Exhale, right foot between the hands. Spin the back heel down. Cartwheel open, warrior two. And we're going to hold warrior two, so we're in a more static hold now, more passive holding. Gaze can follow the fingertips. You want to feel centered between the feet. A couple more breaths here. Inhale, straight leg reverse, reach it up. Exhale, modified side angle. Right forearm, right thigh. We're here for about 6 or 7 breaths. So you can stay in modified or you can drop down to full side angle, right hand inside the right shin if you want to. We have tapped into external rotation, but that, again, it's your choice. What feels good to me today? Only go for more sensation if you need more sensation. Last full breath here. Inhale, reach to the left hand. Exhale, left hand sweeps the earth, pivot a quarter turn towards the left. It makes you in a wide leg fold. Inhale, halfway lift. and exhale, fold. And then inhale, pull the spine long. Exhale, right hand down. Inhale, left hand up. Next exhale, left hand down. Inhale, pull the spine nice and long. Exhale, fold. Soften the knees, pivot a quarter turn towards the left. You're in a runner's lunge, facing the back. Inhale, grounded airplane, back leg lifts. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise, fingertips reach. Big sigh, hands to heart center. Inhale, reach it up. We're going to keep the flow going. Exhale, bow, swan dive. We're taking a full rotation. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Left foot steps back. Spin the back heel down. Inhale, cartwheel open, warrior two. And I'll get back out of their screen just a little bit. We're moving into triangle pose. So on an inhale, straighten the front leg. Exhale, surf the torso forward from the waist. Drop the right hand down. Inhale, left hand can rotate open or come straight to sky. And hold in triangle. Using shin, block, or floor, whatever works for you. You're here for about four more breaths, so really enjoy triangle. Do you see what that feels like to put it behind your foot and if that gives you more open or less stability? Better? Okay. Okay. And there is not right or wrong either way, so always listen to your body, regardless of what me or another guide might share. If that doesn't feel right to Jody, then she would move it back in. She needs to do what's best for her. We're going to keep this moving along a horizontal plane, which means we're going to fold down again. So take an inhale, reach to that left hand. As you exhale, right knee bends. Sweep the left hand to the earth. Pivot a quarter turn towards the left. You're in a wide leg fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. We're moving to Skandasana, right side. If your legs or ankles or knees just don't like this or don't want to do it, you can stay in a fold. Otherwise, inhale, pull the spine long and exhale, sink to Skandasana. You can see that their right toes turn out to the corner, right heel in, and their left toes face up. Jody's taking hands to heart, and Linda's taking the bind. Hands can also stay on the ground if you need to. That's where it is for me. So always listening and doing what's best for you. Release any bind. Bring the hands back to the floor. On an inhale, come up to wide leg. Pull the spine nice and long. Exhale, fold. And we will hold this on the back side of the mandala. So go ahead and soften the knees. Pivot a quarter turn towards the left. You're in a runner's lunge facing the front. Oops, about fail. Inhale, grounded airplane. Back leg lifts. Exhale, fold. Right foot meets the left. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, fold. Inhale, push off the earth and rise. Fingertips reach. Big sigh, hands to heart. And we're going to take tree pose here, standing on the left foot. Bring that right foot up where you want it to be. And it can be on the ground, below the knee, above the knee. It can be in half lotus. Hands can be at heart center or grow your tree. Your hands can be any way you want. It can be in a cross pattern down by the hips. You have three more breaths here. We're moving to Krishna. So on an inhale, reach up, pull your right knee in, give it a little bounce. Exhale, cross over Krishna. Bend into the right knee, push your right palm towards the, well, it's for us, it's towards the window, but you're twisting to the left. Now on an inhale, push off your front foot, bring it back by the left, reach up, big sigh, all the way through the center. Now inhale, out to the side and up, and again, down through center. This is downward pranic movement of breath. Inhale, out and up. Exhale, pause at the heart. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, bow, swan dive. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. This time moving into full side plank, following the same pattern of energy, which is opening to the left right now. Right foot steps back. Left foot stacks on top of right. If this is too much sensation, you can be in modified. Hold and breathe here. Take the variation that's right for you. One more full breath. Nice. Beautiful, guys. Next exhale, left hand comes down. Now push the hips back to down dog. Come off those wrists. Inhale, roll forward. Exhale, lower down. Move through your vinyasa. We'll meet in down dog. So the vinyasa and that back and forth helps to transition that energy back to a neutral as we begin to develop onto the right side. Inhale, lift the toes. Exhale, lower the heels. You got a cramp or anything, Jody? You're good? Okay, yeah. All right. Inhale, left leg lifts. Exhale, left foot between the hands. Spin the back heel down and inhale, cartwheel open, warrior two. Now, take time to find your base. Left toes are facing forward. Feel centered between the feet. You have about four more breaths, so it's one we hold. Mm-hmm. I might have to get my, I need that. Then inhale, straight leg reverse, reach up. Exhale, modified side angle. Did I do that on the other side? Is that right? Is that correct? We did straight leg reverse. Sometimes I forget. Now we're holding this side angle, 6-7 breaths, so you can certainly drop it to full side angle at any time that you would like to. So you don't have to go for it right now, but just mentioning that we're here for a little bit. Breathing here, you can always use a block inside. So it's interesting. I find that on the side angles, the block on the inside feels more supportive to me. And the triangle on the outside. But again, you choose what works for you. Now take an inhale. Now as you exhale, right hand sweeps the earth, pivot a quarter turn towards the right. You're in a wide leg fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Then inhale, pull the spine long. Exhale, left hand down and inhale, right hand to sky. Exhale, right hand down. This is just following the pattern of energy. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Everything's moving to the right. Pivot a quarter turn towards the right. You're in a runner's lunge facing the back. Next inhale, grounded airplane, back leg lifts. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, fold. Inhale, rise. Fingertips reach. Big sigh, hands to heart center. Inhale, take it up. Exhale, bow, swan dive. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Right foot steps back. Spin the back heel down. Inhale, cartwheel open to warrior two. Exhale, here. Find your warrior two footing. We're moving into triangle. Inhale, straighten the front leg. Exhale, surf the torso forward. Left hand down. It can be shin, block, or floor. Inhale, right hand to sky. It can be a rotation or straight up. And then it's 6 or 7 breaths here. So in warrior two, triangle, and side angle, these all use the energy vyana. It's expansion from the center heart of the heart out. So the heart and lungs support warrior two and are utilized and supportive in warrior two, in triangle as well, and side angle. You want the energy flowing nice and free, so be mindful if you're reaching too far down your leg, if you want to lift up onto the shin a little bit. See what that would look like, Linda, just to show. You see Jody did the same thing, just lifting up, just to see if it helps us open a little bit. Just playing with your poses. Remember, they're not locked positions. Nice. You can feel the expansion. Now, we're getting ready to transition, so take an inhale. Exhale, left knee bends, right hand sweeps the earth, pivot a quarter turn towards the right. You're in a wide leg fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. You can stay here or we're going to move to Skandasana. Inhale, heart pulls forward. Exhale, left side Skandasana. Left toes out, left heel in. Hands can stay on the ground. They can be at the heart. They can bind like Linda's doing. So choose what works for you. Nice, guys. Then release any bind. Inhale, back up to wide leg. Heart pulls forward. And this is where we're going to exhale, fold, and hold. So you're here for several breaths. 6 or 7 breaths here. My mic thing's pushing into my head, so if you see me working over here, that's what it is. And here you choose, you can see that each of the girls have chosen a different path that works for them. Linda's got a little more heart opening and shoulder opening happening here, and Jody's working on the hamstrings, moving into hands back behind her. And this is all just about what do I need, and us listening to our bodies to find out what works best for us. A couple more breaths, and I'll give you some silence. Last full breath, so we're getting ready to transition. Hands come underneath the shoulders. Inhale, pull the spine nice and long. Exhale, fold. Soften the knees, pivot a quarter turn towards the right. You're in a runner's lunge, facing the front. Next inhale, grounded airplane, back leg lifts. Exhale, fold, left foot meets the right. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise, fingertips reach. Big sigh, hands to heart center. Moving into tree pose, standing on that right foot, left foot comes up where you want it to be. Choose any arms that support your tree. Couple more breaths. Now we're transitioning to Krishna. So inhale, reach both hands up, pull the left knee in, give a little bounce. There's your center point. Exhale, cross over the right foot, bending them to the left knee. Push the energy towards the right, left palm facing out, right hand to sky. Next inhale, push off that left foot, bring it back by the right. Now big sigh through the center. And then inhale out and up. Big sigh through the center again. Inhale, reach it out and up. And exhale, pause at the heart. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, bow, swan dive. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. We're moving into left side plank. Left foot steps back. Right foot stacks on top of left, or left knee can come down and be in modified. Right hand reaches to sky. Just a couple of more breaths. It's not a long hold. Nice. Take an inhale, and as you exhale, right hand comes down. Push it back, down dog. Inhale, roll forward to plank. Exhale, lower down, move through your vinyasa. We'll meet in down dog. Inhale, lift the toes. Exhale, lower the heels. Inhale, right leg lifts. Exhale, right foot between the hands. Pull the spine nice and long, heart forward, hands back, and inhale, rise, fingertips reach, crescent lunge. Sorry, I should have cued that. Exhale here. Now you can stay in a static hold here. Especially if you're new to the practice, you don't want to try that transitioning, this up and down. But I like that when I'm switching from open to center to tap into it. So on an inhale, using your hand, reach it up and straighten the front leg. Exhale, right palm comes down and right knee bends. Inhale, lift it out and up. Exhale, lower. Inhale, out and up. Exhale, lower. One more, inhale out and up. Now exhale, lower, and start to lower the back knee all the way down. Gently, gently, gently. Then inhale, right hand reaches up. Join the fingertips. If you like, bring the hands behind the head. Lift the heart up. Now remember that movement is optional. You can stay in crescent lunge, then bring the hands down and come into modified. Two more breaths here. Inhale, reach the hands up. Exhale, bring the hands down. Gently push it back to split spread. Inhale, roll forward, low lunge. Exhale, push back. It's just moving energy around. Inhale, roll forward. Now exhale, push back to hold. We're gonna move into a twist and we're gonna combine the open hip and the squared hip pattern to ring out the dantian. So we're gonna move into a twist that takes us to half moon. Take a couple more breaths here. Just make sure that hamstring's nice and open. Last full breath here. And then we're gonna move into a twist. So on the inhale, heart starts to lift up. On the exhale, the left hand comes down. You can use a block as Linda's moving to use and Jody is. And inhale your right hand to sky, keeping your right hip pulled back. So it's a big stretch for that IT band from the hip to the knee. One more full breath. Let's do one more. One more. Now we're going to transition to half moon. So take an inhale. As you exhale, right hand comes down as right knee bends. And you come into that lunge. Next inhale, grounded airplane. Exhale here. Next inhale, open up half moon pose. So you're going from a contraction to expansion, which helps ring out the lower dantian. Nice, nice, guys. Just a couple more breaths here. You can see that both of them have lots of energy. Nice and beautiful, guys. Really pretty. Take an inhale, and on the exhale, close it off. Left hand comes down, but left leg stays lifted. Just square it off. Now inhale, reach through the back heel. Exhale, left foot meets the right. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise. Fingertips reach. Big sigh, hands to heart center. Inhale, reach it up. And exhale, bow, swan dive. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Now we're going to put these little rollbacks in here. So go ahead and come down to a toe squat. And this is for the mere sake of just moving energy around. We're going to drop down to our bottoms and roll back and forth three or four times. And then you can do a forward fold to a jump, a squat to a jump back. So you can bring it forward, jump back, or you can go to forward fold, step it back. But you're going to move through a vinyasa and we'll meet in down dog. Nice, guys, nice. Inhale, lift the toes. Exhale, lower the heels. Inhale, left leg lifts. Exhale, left foot between the hands. Stay on the ball of the back foot. We're moving to that crescent lunge. Heart forward, hands back. Find your balance first. Inhale, rise. Exhale, here. Now, I was talking a little bit, so I'll just keep them here. One more full breath before we start the movement. Now, on an inhale, reach through the fingertips, straighten the front leg. Exhale, lower it down, left palm. Inhale, palm up and out. Exhale, lower. So that palm helps move that energy around. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. And exhale, lower. Now, inhale, lift. This time, exhale, lower and start to drop that back knee. So really slowly come down. Inhale, left hand joins the right. Exhale, bring the hands behind you. Lift the heart up. And these are all options. The hand can stay on the front. And again, you don't have to take that movement. Inhale, reach the hands up. Exhale, hands come down. Gently push it back to split prep. Inhale, roll forward. Exhale, push back. One more time. Inhale, roll forward. And exhale, push back. And we're going to hold it. Heart forward and fold. And just get into that hamstring first. So only a few times in some dana yoga will you see us use open hip and squared hip in the same time, and it's generally to ring out something, ring out the non-TM. We talked before class about energy being funny this week, so hopefully this will help set things to balance in the body. One more full breath here. Then on an inhale, start to lift the heart up. Exhale, right hand down, left hand to hip or sky. That left hip pulls back, the heart pulls forward. You're trying to stack the shoulders. Beautiful, guys. Now take a couple more breaths here. And when we do transition to half moon, we're going to try to do it all smooth in one movement. So when we do start to bring that left hand down, let the left knee bend as it comes down so there's no pressure on the back of the left knee. Take an inhale, exhale, left hand comes down, left knee bends, tuck the back toes, next inhale, grounded airplane, sweep it open, half moon. And eventually those can be done just an exhale down, inhale, half moon. Nice. One more full breath. Now take an inhale, and as you exhale, close it off, right hand down, level the hips. Take an inhale here, exhale, fold, right foot by the left. Inhale, halfway lift, exhale, fold. Come down to that toe squat. You don't have to take these. It's three or four rollbacks, but this time it's just up to a standing forward fold, not a jump back. And big haws when you're coming forward. Release. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise, fingertips reach. Big sigh, hands to heart center. We're going to work off the top of the mat now. Inhale, hands reach up. Exhale, bow, swan dive. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Left foot steps back. Keep the feet hip distance apart. We're moving to warrior one. Back heel spins down. Heart pulls forward. Hands sweep back. Inhale, rise. Now exhale, pull out to goddess. Turn your palms up so you can feel the energy here. On an inhale, straighten and reach. Exhale, bend. Beautiful. Inhale, reach. And exhale, bend. One more and we'll hold. Inhale, reach. Now on this one, just exhale your right elbow down. Now reach through your fingertips. Index finger and thumb can join if you want Gaia Mudra, but you don't have to. Whatever works for you. Anything that I'm saying, it's just a suggestion. Couple more breaths here. Now inhale, reach the right hand straight in the front leg. Exhale, bring the hands down, bend back into the front knee, lift the back heel, drop the back knee, push it back to splits prep. Inhale, roll forward one time. Exhale, push back. Now inhale, come forward. Exhale, tuck the back toes, come off the back knee. We're going to spin the back heel down and take pyramid pose. It doesn't have to square off, but just pyramid. Heart pulls forward and fold. You're here for about 5-6 breaths. Jody, how are your hamstrings? A fan? Thank you, Lisa. Now, even though we're filming you guys, if anything doesn't feel right or you need to say, please take the time to share it. We'll be close with our internet. Linda, you want a fan? Yeah. Yeah, because if you're not comfortable, you're not going to want to do it again. So we want you to, And see, I'm freezing. My toes are freezing right now. Soften the front knee. On an inhale, come up to standing splits and hold. Push off that left leg. Three more breaths. So heart is down for a little bit. Take an inhale, reach through the left foot. Exhale, left foot meets the right. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, fold. Inhale, rise, fingertips reach. Big sigh, hands to heart center. Now we're going to move into warrior three to figure four, and we're going to do it with this. We're going to do big toe to warrior three with a split variation to figure four. You can take one of these or two of these or the three in combination. So we work a lot in combination, which I enjoy. So it's a lot of center, a lot of core work, a lot of center point work. Let me just show this before then, and I'm not warm, but when you're coming into it, you want to make sure you move with the breath. So shoulders over hips, anchor up above. The inhale is going to find extension. The exhale will bend. We'll hold for a couple breaths. Take an inhale here, reach through your hands. As you exhale, swing it forward. Inhale, take it up. And exhale, sink to figure four. So we're not holding any of those points too long. Again, if you want to go for big toe and hold, you can. If you want to go for the warrior three, you can. But make sure you use those hands to help you pull into it. All right, so standing on the left foot, right knee comes up where you want it to be. Right knee comes up. Peace fingers hold the right big toe. Left hand on the hip. Shoulders over the hips. Anchor up above. On an inhale, find extension. Exhale here. One more full breath. Now take an inhale and exhale, bend, release. Inhale here. And then exhale, cartwheel it forward into that warrior three. Nice. Push through both pieces, through the hand and back foot. Now inhale, lift it up and come into figure four. Exhale here. Nice. Inhale, reach it up, prana, and exhale out to the side. Inhale up through center, and exhale out to the side. One more time, inhale up. Now exhale, step it out to mountain and hold and breathe here. Shoulders roll down the back, chin is level, reach through the crown of the head. Hold and breathe here. You have about five full breaths in mountain pose. Inhale, widen the palm, reach the hands up. Big sigh out through the mouth, hands to heart. Our last standing sequence, inhale, reach it up. It's the other side. Exhale, bow, swan dive. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Right foot steps back. Spin the back heel down, keep the feet hip distance apart. Heart pulls forward, hands sweep back. Inhale, rise. Now exhale, pull it out, goddess arms. Turn the palms up and inhale, straighten and reach. Exhale, bend. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, bend. Last one, inhale, straighten. Now this time, just exhale, left elbow back. And that helps to keep that left hip pulled back. We'll hold here. Now on an inhale, straighten both arms, reach straight in the front leg. Exhale, hands come down, front knee bends, back heel lifts, drop down to the back knee, push it back to splits prep. Whew, that's a lot in one. Inhale, roll forward. Exhale, push back. Now inhale, come forward. Exhale, tuck the back toes, come off the back knee. Spin the back heel down, adjust your back foot for pyramid, not to square it off, but just to where you're comfortable. Halfway lift and fold. That is our heat system cutting on. Lisa's going to grab it. It's loud. So if you heard that, was our heat system. All right, we're transitioning to standing splits. Soften the front knee. Next inhale, right leg lifts. Exhaling here, hold and breathe. Inhale, reach to the ball of the right foot. Exhale, right foot meets the left. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise, fingertips reach. Big sigh, hands to heart. We're moving into that big toe figure, warrior three, figure four. Take any pieces that you want from this. Standing on the right foot, right hand to the hip. Left knee comes in. Peace fingers hold the left big toe, shoulders over hips. Inhale, extends the right hand up. Exhale here. Next inhale finds extension. Exhale here. One more full breath. Take an inhale. On the exhale, bend the knee, release the toe, extend the hands. Take an inhale. Exhale, cartwheel into your warrior three. Push through the left hand, reach through the back heel. Next inhale, tilt it up. Exhale, cross it over, figure four, and set your center point. Inhale, lift up. Big sigh out to the side. Inhale, up through center. Exhale, out to the side. Next time, mountain. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, out to mountain. Now, before we set this mountain to hold, which we will, and then we're coming to the floor, we're going to inhale, squeeze the shoulders towards the ears, and exhale, just drop and release. Inhale, squeeze. Exhale, release. Inhale, squeeze. Exhale, release. Now, inhale, pull the shoulders towards the ears. Exhale, draw them down the back. Two more. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Last one. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Now, as you lower that, you'll feel that energy run down the spine and sometimes back in the Mingmen. So just kind of bend the knees and let that tailbone then, you know, reset your stance for mountain in case you pulled some energy down. And then reach through the crown of the head. Chin is level. Eyes can be opened or closed. And you have five full breaths here. Inhale, widen the palm, reach the hands up. Big sigh out through the mouth, hands to heart. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, bow, swan dive. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Come down to a toe squat, gently rock it back and forth three or four times, and then just up to seated. Jody, are you good with doing a couple more minutes? Okay. And then from seated, we're going to move in to half virasana. So we're going to come to the center of your mat. And we're going to do our back extension, get into more back extension on the floor. And you don't know if you're good there or not. You're both. Sorry. Yeah, so you can use, and Jody's right. You can use with a bolster, without a bolster, sometimes a blanket. Are you good do you want a bolster, Linda? Okay. All right, so we're going to keep the left leg extended, fold the right foot behind us. And then we're going to gently make our way onto our back, whether it's with a bolster or not. Now that you're coming down, do you guys want those fans off or you want them on? It doesn't bother me. It's what you want. Is it too much wind? Do you want it low? Okay. I just didn't know if it needed to be low just because you know how it feels when you get down on the floor. They are hot mamas, aren't they? Yes. So you're down for a little bit. If you have knee issues at home, so you're here for about a minute and a half, couple of minutes, just to get into because that's a lot of hip flexion we've been in, and we're going to move it back into extension. If you cannot fold your knee right here, you can just leave your leg extended. You're still getting hip extension. You're still in back extension. We are making our way towards bridge, so you probably don't, you can do the feet together, knees out wide, but that's external rotation. So choose what works for you, and I'll be quiet for a little bit. In fact, while we wait, I'm going to step out of the scene. Last few breaths here. Get ready to come out. If you're lying flat on your back, you may want to release your leg before you come up. You don't have to come up to fold the other side unless you want to. If you're on your bolster, you may need to come up to switch. So I'm like a phantom. I'm not there. You can just hear my voice, okay? Like magic. And you viewers can't see our little studio dog, but she is so cute laying on her bolster. We'll show you in our next video. Once you're settled, just relax here. You have about a minute and a half. Last few breaths here. Gently start to either unfold the leg or lift it up. We're going to be coming back onto our back, but if you had a bolster, you'll want to come off your bolster. And again, I'm just the phantom voice. The girls are moving. So we're going to come back onto our back, and we're moving into bridge posture. So if you would like restorative bridge, you certainly can take it just with a block under the sacrum. If you want regular bridge, we're not holding for a long time. So feet hip distance apart, tailbone lengthened so it presses the low back towards the ground, and on an inhale, push into your feet to lift your hips. Exhaling here and hold and breathe. You can walk your shoulders underneath. You can clasp your hands and hold and breathe here. Last two breaths here. Take an inhale. And then clench the butt cheeks, just to protect the spine, and exhale, slowly lower. Take the feet mat distance apart. If you like, you can drop the knees towards each other or not. I actually just like my feet hip distance apart, so I should have just said that. Whatever works for you. Yeah. We're going to take one more, and then we'll counter it. Coming back to your second bridge, feet hip distance apart, lengthening the tailbone, ankles under the knees, inhale, lift up and hold. Josh, you can still hear me, right? Take an inhale, and as you exhale, slowly lower. And then just pause here. Just give it a breath. And we're done with back extension. So you can bring, if you'd like, bring the feet together, the knees out wide. You're in bound angle. And let's just take a couple of prana building breaths, just a couple of releases. Big inhale. Big sigh. Inhale. And big sigh. And let's take one that we hold and then just big, big sigh to let it go. So start at your feet. Inhale into your soles of your feet. Inhale ankles. Inhale shins. Inhale knees. Inhale thighs. Inhale belly. Inhale chest, rib cage. Inhale into your shoulders, arms, throat. Inhale face, top of head. Keep inhaling. Then hold the breath as long as you can. When you're ready to release, it's with a big sigh, whenever that's right for you. And then on an inhale, bring the knees towards each other. Exhaling here, feet hip, shift the hips over to the left, drop the knees over to the right. We're just taking a couple of breaths each side, and we'll come up for a short twist sequence on the floor and then back down for Shavasana. Slowly lift this up to center. Shift the hips over to the right. Drop the knees to the left. It's about 5 breaths here. These twists help release the low back after back extension. Energetically, they help put back the crossweave fabric in the body. Inhale, let's bring it back up. Exhale, unwind the legs if they were crossed. Shift the hips back to center. Now, you can roll up to seated, but that can be tough on your back, but you can certainly do what you want. I do that. I'm not, but ideal is to shift over to one side and come up on the side safely. I'm just saying that to you guys at home. I like the roll up. We're going to move into tree on the floor. So left leg extended, right heel in. And we're going to take a twist. Inhale, your right hand reaches up. Exhale, your right hand behind you, your left hand to the outside of the right knee. Now for future, we'll add a little twist section to the same class that is vinyasa, but for now we're gonna do it on the floor. Just holding, reaching. Sorry, my phone, I forgot to cut it off before filming, so if you hear it. Now take an inhale, and on the exhale, return the heart towards the front. Take that right knee and cross it over the left leg. Fold the left leg if you'd like, and we'll take another twist. So you're going to take that right hand behind that left elbow or left hand to the outside of the right knee. Two more breaths here. Now take an inhale, and as you exhale, return back to the front. Unfold the bottom leg, extend the other leg to meet. You're in a Dandasana pose. This is a neutralizer, major neutralizer in some Dana yoga. Remove any excess from the butt cheeks. Inhale, reach the hands up, and exhale, fold. Now, if you find in a lot of rounding in the low back, you can come back up to lifted position and just bring the hands behind you and just keep trying to get the hips pressing to a forward tilt, anterior tilt of the hips. You have five more full breaths here. Slowly on an inhale, start to lift this up. Now as you exhale, you're going to slide that left heel in for tree on the floor with the left legs. Okay. Now inhale, your left hand reaches up. Exhale, left arm behind you, right hand to the outside of that left knee. On the inhales, lengthen the spine. On the exhales, try to increase the twist to the left. A few more breaths here. Take an inhale, and as you exhale, bring it back to the front. Take that left foot and cross it over the right leg. Fold the right leg in if you like. Now, I can't do that, so I keep mine extended. Just know that is an option, the bottom leg. And then left hand behind you, right hand or right elbow past the left knee. Last night, Linda Bynd, she found in that. It was killer. Don't think you have to bind today. I was just saying it was just awesome. It was pretty. Yeah. Beautiful, guys. Nice, Jody. Take an inhale and exhale, return to the front. Unfold the legs, Dandasana pose again. Remove any excess. Inhale, reach up, and exhale, fold. You have five more breaths here. Last full breath here. Slowly start to lift this up. Bend the knees, shift the hips forward, palms on the mat, and then make your way to your savasana, whatever that might be for you. You might want it on your belly. You might want it on your back. You might want to bolster under your knees. You want to bolster under your knees, Jody? Okay. You're welcome. Now, would y'all like blankets over you? How about eye pillows? Okay. So once you're down, take any cleansing breaths that you'd like. Big inhales and big sighs. And it's a time to, again, as you notice at the beginning and the end, we just let go. You've moved a lot of energy around. And so, which is awesome. And now we just want to let go. So just rest. Linda, did you want one? Okay. It's time to deepen your breath. Movement back into your fingers and toes. And of course, if you want longer, just tune me out and stay there as long as you like. As you start to make your way out of Shavasana, if you're coming out now, maybe you kick your bolster away. Maybe you lengthen the body. Move it. Have you roll over to fetal, whatever works for you. That concludes our class for today. We're so grateful for your presence and joining us today in a Savasana Yoga Basic Vinyasa class. We'll close with an om. We hope that you join us here at home. This is a great way for us to express together, and it's a good expression of the essence of each self. So palms face up to receive, face down to close off. Take an inhale and a big sigh and let it go. If you'd like to om, take an inhale. Om. Inhale. Big sigh and let it go. Allow your hands to come to heart center. Thank you so much for letting me share in your yoga practice and for you sharing your spirit, breath, energy, and heart. Namaste.